Sit.
It's going to be unbelievable. The fans, everybody around the world, the fighters. This is just one of those things.
And now it's time for our tale of the tape. Rocky Marciano. He's 5'10" tall, one of the greatest heavyweights to ever live. Undefeated. And in the other corner, Rocky Marciano, 201 pounds of pure terror. This man is an absolute machine. He is the greatest.
This bout is scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner, here is a Hall of Fame legend from Brockton, Massachusetts, a Ring Magazine world champion, and an undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, the Brockton blockbuster, Rocky Marciano. Fighting out of the blue corner, here is the Olympic gold medalist and legend of boxing.
One of the hottest tickets around. He waited a long time, and now we've got this fight. How did he absorb that hook?
You've got to try and push him off, make him go into the rope. You've got to sometimes fight fire with fire. Put him on the blind side of the referee. Get him out of here.
Can do that. This round could go either way. 10 seconds.
Are we about to witness history? The great Rocky Marciano in serious trouble.
Not much to write home about in that round, huh, John? Let's get it started in round three. He misses with that jab. And negatives in the heavyweight division are the same. You can win the fight with one punch, and you can lose the fight in one punch.
How does that carry so much power? Of course they're going to look like knockout, because it makes a mat a little bit shorter. You don't get paid any extra for overtime.
To finish the show right now. Can he find that one big shot? How are they still standing? Nice exchanges from both men in this round. He fails to score with that left hook. Gets off the way of that left hand. This fighter's certainly not going to outthrow them. You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. Seemed to be like a feel-out round. What do you think, Johnny?
I know that.
Here we go in round four. Who's going to land the first big shot? Right punch. Punch. And he misses with that jab. And you've got someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with
it? You have a fighter that's got great footwork and that great hand speed. It's so hard, but it's an uphill battle.
Marciano fighting to survive. He's never been knocked out.
Big shots from both these fighters. Got to be careful, though. And that's exactly where he doesn't need to be. Disaster averted. Rocky Marciano. No secret who has the dog. On to the fifth we go. Got caught clean by a left hook. today's second win. You've got to find it somehow.
We've got two fighters that are absolutely shattered. What can...
Show us something, Rocky. Looks like they've shaken it off. Nice exchanges from both men in this round. Misses with that jab. We've seen in the past from this fighter, they don't get concerned when they lose some of the earlier rounds because they know they've got that power that can strike at any moment.
Todd, we know one of these fighters can knock you out with a simple jab. They're that powerful.
You know the scorecards are going to be all over the place in this one. These two fighters promised us great action. They didn't give it to us in that round.
Why not keep your eye on the ball? This is when you get knocked out. Don't close your eyes now.
Let's start the six. Threw the hook, didn't land. And he just missed that left jab. There's no way this fighter can go punch for punch. Their resistance to these blows just isn't the same.
The problem with having a chin that everybody knows if they hit you, you're hurt, you're gone. You've got to protect that, but you've also got to get your shots off. And don't forget, you can bang too.
Exchanges from both men in this round. Why aren't they keeping their gloves up? High punch. You've got someone with that hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
I've never seen a fighter so fast in my life. How did you deal with this?
You gotta hope they went out of steam.
Very close round with 10 seconds to go. Which fighter is winning this bout? So important. Each one of these athletes is going to be the first to get rocked. Can't connect with that right hook. He just misses with that jab. They call it the chin. How strong is your chin? Do you have a glass chin? These are things that can affect the fight.
Because you've got a good chin doesn't mean you've got leather skin. It means you can still get caught. So you've got to go for those pointed areas over the eyebrow, the cheekbone. You've just got to try and cut them, skin them, go for speed.
These two are the perfect dance partner. Good left hook. As swing and a miss with the right hook. Right hook is scoring.
So frustrating.
A very competitive round with 10 seconds left. Who's winning this fight right now? I have no idea.
That was super tight. I dread being a judge.
Me if I'm wrong, but when you're dealing with someone with so much speed, you've got to get your timing right.
So you're getting in there with somebody that's so fast, you're prepared to take a licking, because you've got to get some before you get them close.
Can they figure out the combination to this safe? Both of these men showing exceptional chins, by the way. Movies, the training scenes, the gym work, that's what it all boils down to. Who's going to have more endurance?
What can they change? Can they slow the pace down? Can they hope to knock them out early? What can they do?
This round's still up for grabs with just 10 seconds to go. This fight could not be any closer, could it, Johnny?
Too hard to split. Do you listen to your head or your heart?
Who's going to be the first one to get rocked? That big hook doesn't land. Misses with that big right hand. Nope, that hook won't score. How nervous would you get when you know you're facing a big puncher like this guy that can seriously hurt you?
Sometimes when you get in there with someone that's so powerful, you've got to be thinking. You've just got to be smarter than them. You've got to be like a little Fagin and pickpocket them.
Big shots from both these fighters. Got to be careful, though. Neither man really defending themselves. Exchange here from both men. You hear people talk about a boxer's chin. Do they have a good chin? Do they have a glass jaw? Those are questions that are being answered here tonight.
What a gift. What a gift.
This round could go either way. 10 seconds to go. This fight is closer than two pages and a... He's going to be the first one to get caught. Swing and a miss. You can tell he's stronger, but he's not faster. Stamina is so important for these two fighters because it allows them to use their skills throughout the match. It can all come down to who's in better shape.
Midway through the fight, if you are tired, this can be the loneliest place in the world. If you cheated,
now we're gonna find out. Back and forth they go, neither fighter willing to back down. Left shot lands. Job by him to block that jab. Power is obviously the great equalizer in boxing, but when you know your opponent is relying on that so heavily, how do you deal with it?
Power. That power might be the do or die. That power might be the equalizer.
Swing and a miss with that left hook. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one. I don't know which fighter is winning this battle.
So important.
Who's going to be the first one to get buzzed? Jab doesn't find a home. He caught him there with a left hook. How much confidence do you build when your opponents hit you with their best shot and you walk right through?
Tough. You know what? Sometimes on a day when you fight like that and you punch them, you just want to win. You want that spaceship to come and lift you out of there because you think, what the hell am I going to do now?
Can they figure out the combination to this sink? And they get out of the way of that left hand. No doubt that this fighter's power can change the fight around in an instant. You can't afford to make one single minor mistake. So 10 seconds left. This one could go either way. Who will be buzzed first? And he misses with the left uppercut. A
tenth miss.
Oh, and he caught him with an uppercut.
You got someone with the hand speed that this fighter possesses. How do you deal with it?
Let me explain to you about a fast fighter that's got hand speed and footwork. They're relaxed, they're confident, they know they just have to quick burst, boom! In a split second, they've let four shots go. Their footwork has got them out of the way. And these guys are so relaxed, and that's why they can maintain this all the way through a fight.
Some nice exchanges from both men in this round. Quick punch scores. Man really defending themselves. We hear that old phrase, second win. You've got to find it somehow.
What can they change? They can change their attitude. They can change their nervous system for a certain amount of punches per round. Because
a very competitive round with 10 seconds left.
This is the last thing we expected. What a fight, what a style, what a pace to get a unanimous decision. That is mad. I didn't see that coming. I thought this would be tight. This is nowhere near tight.